Well, Cal Quickshire, there's been some peaks of some troughs. We know there's a major trough, wasn't there, when he hurt himself at the Grand Prix of the Americas, missed a couple of races, missed Argentina, came back for Jerez actually, but crashed out of the race. But then that great peak, and he was up there on the podium in Aragon in very, very difficult conditions on the older spec Ducati. It's on the GP14, but with the lack of updates because they know he's heading off to Honda and on the front row then here for the first time on a Ducati motorcycle. What can Pedrosa do? He did come through Q1 for the first time this year, but he's right up there, fifth on the grid. And the weekend started off very, very badly indeed, with a real lack of traction on the rear end, and he's got that together now. Let's see how he can fare though across the 27 lap race distance.
Yeah, got to make a good start, Danny Pedrosa. Something that he's not been doing of late. He does have a few problems riding the bike when it's full of fuel towards the end of a race. He's as quick as the race leaders, but of course he's dropped off that leading pack by then, or he's trying to fight his way back towards it. And that's why he is where he is in the championship, and it's a terrific battle for second place.
Guys, I'm sorry I have to butt in. I'm down here with Australian actor Eric Banner. Eric, down here on the MotoGP grid, what do you make of this all? Are you a big fan of this show?
Yeah, it's my local track, so very privileged to be able to, you know, just shoot down the road and be here and watch it every week. And so to have it in your backyard, it's just too good to be true.
And what about, who's your money on here? Obviously, Mark doesn't have much to lose. He's got the championship sewed up, but we've got Jorge Valentino. Danny still fighting it out for second.
Yeah, my money's on Jorge today. I mean, he's always been strong at this track. I think it suits his style, and the bike's coming good. So hopefully we'll have a banging race, and I'll get nice and close.
Fantastic. Thank you very much.
Yeah, a banging race. That's what I like to hear. That's going to be our new expression, isn't it? We want a banging race, and certainly we've had a banging performance so far from Bradley Smith. So close to a front row start. It's looked really strong all weekend, hasn't it?
Certainly has. Right up there then, fourth on the grid for the first time since the Spanish Grand Prix back in 87. We've got two Brits in the top four of the grid.
Yeah, that is amazing. Neil McKenzie and Rob McInerney. We have been talking about it. It's not me trying to be super clever. At Jerez. Here he is, Aleix Espargaró, second row start. I think he had a penalty point for being a naughty boy in the practice start zone, isn't he? But I think that's probably going to worry him too much. Good battle between himself and his brother, Paul, for the family honour in the World Championship. And he starts right in front of Paul. On the grid. He's sixth fastest on the second row. Paul is ninth fastest on the third row. There he is, Mick Doohan. He is a MotoGP legend, five times world champion. Some great rides at Phillip Island. And I tell you what, he seems to be thoroughly enjoying himself, doesn't he?
Certainly does. We know he's been flying his helicopter over Surfers Paradise as well the last few days, very much enjoying life. Jorge Lorenzo then, front row of the grid. Second race in a row, actually, that we've got three different manufacturers on the front row. Honda and Pole, Ducati second, Yamaha here third. There again is another example of the peaks and troughs. But look at those last seven races.
Right. Seven races, all podium finishes and two wins. And those two wins have come at the last two races in Aragon and in Motegi. And he won the race here last year. He's got to be pretty close. He's got to be there or thereabouts. But Marquez has got absolutely nothing to lose. You know, and he's also got the cheese grater. He starts from that third row of the grid, seventh fastest.
Guys, I'm just going to bring you down to the grid with Wilco Zeenberg, team manager with Jorge Lorenzo. Wilco, the talk. Many people predicting a Marquez versus Lorenzo again. I think people want to see it. Jorge looking strong, but Marquez also. What do you think Jorge has to do to win today?
Well, as we know that Jorge always likes to be in the front, so he needs to have a good start and try to get a good rhythm straight away, because the wind is a little bit of a question mark factor. So this morning the wind, we had tailwind and it's turned around completely. So that can influence a little bit the behavior of the bike. And we have to see how he is able to manage that. But, you know, first of all, a good start and try to get in the rhythm and see who is able to follow.
What about the cooler temperatures, though? Do you reckon that could play in Yamaha's favour?
For sure, it's not a negative point for us, because we choose to use the 31 front tyre. And if it would have been too hot, it would have been for sure a little bit negative. But at the moment, we are quite happy with the temperature.
Great. Thanks a lot, Wilco.
There you go, there's Phillip Island at its very, very best. Surf beaches at the end there, an amazing promontory called the Nobbies. There are thousands of seabirds, there's the seal rocks. We've seen wallabies, we've seen koalas, we've seen animals that I don't even know what they are. It's been fantastic.
Stephen
so
Bradley
we're in Australia.
There.
And now we're going to hear Jackson Thomas sing Advance Australia Fair.
Soil, our home is girt by sea. Our land abounds in nature's gifts of beauty, rich and rare. In history's page, let every stage advance Australia fair. In joyful strains, then let us sing.
Well, and Jackson Thomas finished second in the recent voice competition on Australian television. And we're in Australia. We're ready to go. Let battle commence here at Phillip Island. 27 laps, round 16 of the championship. Vizioso, if he can make a good start, could well be up there in the early stages, but a bit further back than he was in Motegi.
Well, we know he's a rocket ship off the line, don't we, Dovizioso? From that fourth row of the grid, Weldon as well, to Hiroshi Ayama. Went through to Q2 for the first time since the new qualifying format was introduced at the start of last year. Funnily enough, actually, it's his highest qualifying position since this very race 3 years ago, the 2011 Australian Grand Prix.
Guys, just going back to Dovi, I'm down here with Paolo Ciabatti from Ducati. Paolo, I see you guys are mostly going with the softer option rear tyre. These cooler temperatures might be playing to your advantage.
In reality, the question is what front tire to use at the moment. I think Dovi will definitely go with a 35, which is asymmetric. Carl, I think, had the same idea, but maybe changing his mind. We're going to see now.
Okay, thanks a lot, Paolo.
It's that sort of grid for Dylan, isn't it? People changing their tyres on the grid.
But it is worth mentioning. I just wanted to obviously say that the Ducatis, they are going with the softer option rear tyre. I know many are talking about the front, but obviously the rear tyre is still very important when we look at the race.
And there's not many times they can do that, I don't think, is there, Dylan? Not many races they can do that.
No, not at all. But I think with this slight temperature drop, it's certainly going to play in their favour. They don't know how it's going to drop off towards the end. We do know for certain that it is going to last race distance. That is not going to be a problem. We just don't know how much time they might lose towards the end.
Nicky Hayden qualified 15th fastest. The circuit certainly shouldn't cause his wrist too many problems. He's got a great record here, Nicky Hayden. Podiums in 03, 05 and 08, and poles in 05 and 06. And of course, that's the year he went on to win that world title.
Well, Nicky Hayden was being interviewed there by another Australian favourite, Chris Fumulan.
Yeah, he was working for television now. Of course, Grand Prix winner for Suzuki. Carol Abraham had a nasty crash. He had a collision, didn't he, with Danny Pedrosa in free practice four? Certainly it was yesterday. Yep. Anyway, he was okay. Caught Danny Pedrosa a little bit by surprise, but both, as you can see, are okay, and he has qualified on the sixth row of the grid in 16th place.
Alvaro Bautista wasn't the best of qualifying sessions down there in 17th place. Was caught out actually by a rain shower which disrupted Q1, drawing our attention to his 200th career Grand Prix start. It all started in the 125cc class back in 2002. He's running now the style of number on the front of that bike. His number 19 is the style from 2006, which of course was the year he went on to win the 125 title.
He won the title here when he won the race, actually, Alvaro Bautista. Alongside him, Yoni Hernandez. Not his best qualifying. We've seen some very good qualifying from the Colombian. And this is his new teammate for next season, Danilo Petrucci on the IODA. He's qualified 19th on the seventh row of the grid. Of course, he will be with Pramac Ducati next season.
There's Mike Domeglio, a former world champion himself, the 125 champion.
Yeah, and he won the race here again, to win the world title. He certainly won the race here the year he won the world title in 2008.
Yeah, there's a lot of former Grand Prix winners at this particular venue on the grid, aren't there? That is for sure. Towards the back of the grid, then, we've got Michael Laverty completing that seventh row behind Petrucci and Mike Domeglio. Here is the Northern Irishman. We know his brother Eugene will be in the Premier class next year, riding with Aspar.
Yeah, looks like Michael probably will return to the British Superbike Championship. It'll be a great loss to MotoGP. He's really done a good job. And at the back of the grid, well, we have Brock Parks, made his debut here, Grand Prix debut. in 1999 when he finished in the 125cc race and completing the grid. Alex De Angelis really did get caught out by the rain, but Alex De Angelis has two pole positions and two Moto2 wins here, so he'd be particularly disappointed with that rain shower that caught everybody out by surprise right at the start of Q1 yesterday.
BMW safety car pulls away then, 5 minutes to go before the 2014 Australian Grand Prix gets underway. A very exciting prospect at the front of this grid then. Marquez on pole for the 12th time this year. Crutchlow second, Jorge Lorenzo completing the top three. What's going to happen? Now pay a lot of attention because the tyres are more confusing this weekend than ever. Extra soft front then for Smith under Aleix Espargaró. That is the conventional symmetric compound. It can't possibly be the asymmetric. Only the soft compound can be the asymmetric front. We need to pay attention to the rears as well as we look to the likes of the Ducatis Dylan's mentioned. We're going to be running the softer compound rear.
That's a good tyre race as we've had for a long time, and choice-wise, isn't it? It's going to be very interesting indeed. There you go.
So that's interesting. Jorge Lorenzo on the extra soft compound front. Now that's not a surprise because he's favoured that one all weekend long. But Marquez and Crutchlow both on the soft compound.
Actually, Cal Crutchlow did a last minute switch on the grid. Obviously, the TV guys could know they did a last minute switch and just decided to go with the extra soft.
Now there you go. So Marquez soft, but extra soft for Crutchlow and Lorenzo. Thanks, Dylan.
So here we go, front row of the grid, round 16 of the MotoGP World Championship. Jorge Lorenzo, winner of the last two Grand Prix, winner here last year. Cal Crutchlow on the Ducati. First time he's put that Ducati on the front row of the grid all season. And in pole position, it's the 2014 MotoGP World Champion, Marc Marquez. Marquez chases his 12th Grand Prix victory of the season. So welcome back to Phillip Island. I'm Nick Harris, sitting alongside me, Gregory Haynes, down in pit lane, Dylan Gray. MotoGP about to start.
Marquez on pole position then as the world champion for the second time in MotoGP. 12th pole of the season. Can he now take his 12th Grand Prix victory of the season? First front row on a Ducati for Cal Crutchlow. Then it's Lorenzo, winner of the last two races and winner here last year. Bradley Smith, great fourth place from Pedrosa under Aleix Espargaró. Iannone heads up row three from Valentino Rossi. Then it's Paul Espargaró, Dovizioso on the Ducati, Stefan Bradl and Hiroshi Ayama, who is through to Q2 for the first time.
Row five, we have Scott Redding, Hector Barber and Nicky Hamer. That great record here. Karel Abraham, Alvaro Bautista. Happy memories here. His 200th Grand Prix start. And further back, Petrucci, Demeglio, Laverty. And row eight, Brock Parks and Alex De Angelis.
So a lot to play for. We know the teams and constructors' titles are up for grabs here for Honda, for Repsol Honda team. They now just wait for the grid to clear. The last few mechanics from Iota there making their way off the starting grid. We know Marquez has won already 11 times this year. Mick Doohan, the only rider to win 12 premier class races in a single season. He's here today watching on at his home Grand Prix is Mick Doohan. Can Marquez equal that record? Watch out for Bautista, 200th career Grand Prix start. Watch out for Rossi, 250th start in the premier class.
They race down the Gardner Straight into the Doohan corner.
And guys, I have to correct myself now. Crutchlow switched back onto the soft tyre, so much debating going on, so he is on the soft, so apologies to the TV guys, they got it absolutely spot on.
Right.
But yeah, like you say, fantastic bit of tyre war going on there today, and it's going to be so interesting to see how they last towards the end of the race, and also depending if the temperature stays constant, it's warmed up a little bit, and that could play in favour of the Hondas a tiny little bit, because they don't like it when it gets too cool, because they need to get more heat into that rear tyre. If it does get a bit cooler, then we might see the Yamaha's favoured ever so slightly.
Right, keep reminding us of those tyre choices as the race goes on, Dylan, because it could play a very big part. We ride with Paul Espargaró, pole setter and Moto2 winner for the last 2 years.
Where are those temperatures then? Air temperature 16 degrees Celsius, ground temperature 30. We'll keep updating you on the air temperatures as this Grand Prix progresses. It's a 27 lap distance here, just coming up to 4 p.m. local time now. Down to the right-hander, formerly known as MG. This is turn 10. We could see a lot of drama here, as we have done in practice.
We're at Phillip Island. It's round 16 of the MotoGP World Championship. Marquez may have clinched it last week in Motegi, but look at that battle for second place. Rossi and Pedrosa tied on points. Lorenzo right behind them. This is going to be a great battle for the win, also that second place in the championship. But Marc Márquez celebrates that Grand Prix World Championship victory from pole position here at Phillip Island.
Nothing beats the energy and the tension, does it, at the start of a MotoGP race. Three Grand Prix to go this season. We're in Sepang next weekend in Malaysia. For now then, the Australian Grand Prix. Tear off removed for Marc Márquez, calm as ever.
So it's 27 laps of the Phillip Island circuit. It's dry, little bit of wind about. Can Márquez equal Mick Doohan's record? Lights are red, we're underway here in Australia. Not a bad start by Márquez.
And a great start for Crutchlow, also for Jorge Lorenzo. Who's going to get to the Doohan corner first? Look at Bradley Smith around the outside. Bradley Smith side by side with Lorenzo for the lead of the Australian Grand Prix. Bradley Smith made a great start here last year, equally good in 2014. He's pushing Márquez out wide as they get to the Southern Loop for the first time. Márquez goes second. He's now attacking Lorenzo on the inside. That was phenomenal. Marc Márquez passes Lorenzo on the exit of the Southern Loop.
Wow, what a start to the race through the Stoner corner. This very fast left-hander, they'll sit up and break. They're lining up the hairpin first time round. Márquez determined that Lorenzo did not get away, and Smith moves up into second place, then runs it a little bit wide.
Yes, and sat up at the same time by Valentino Rossi was Dani Pedrosa. He drops back slightly then as they came out of turn four for the first time. This is the left-hander of Siberia. Apologies, it's Pol Espargaró in front of Dani Pedrosa. Rossi just behind them, and there is Alessio Espargaró. Now, Crutchlow's dropped back because Crutchlow started this race from the front row. Look at Lorenzo.
Oh, what a place at the hay shed part of the circuit. Up over Lukey Heights they come. We ride with Márquez. Lorenzo wants to get him back. He can't do it at the bottom of the hill. A bit of a wobble there from Smith. Here comes Rossi.
This time he has taken Dani Pedrosa. What a great shot back. That's Pedrosa on the right. Dovizioso just behind us. Looking back then from Valentino Rossi's 250th Premier Class start here this afternoon. Started eighth on the grid, and he's now up there in the top five. The two Czech three riders, they've got great memories of the 250 title win here from the year 2000. But Smith is third, Pol Espargaró fourth at the moment as we start the second of the 27 laps. Look at the sea in the background. They stream their way over the brow of the hill, back down to the Doohan corner. Márquez leads, then it's Lorenzo, then Smith. Slightly wide is Bradley Smith.
Yeah, it's going to be a head-to-head between Lorenzo and Márquez. I don't think there's any doubt about that. Pol Espargaró closing up on Bradley Smith as they go through the Southern Loop, through the Stoner corner. Rossi may have a nibble up the inside here of Pol Espargaró as they break for the hairpin turn four. That caused a lot of problems in Moto2 because of the wind. Here comes Rossi on the brakes. Pol Espargaró trying to go through on Bradley Smith. He's pushed him wide. Can Rossi come through as well? Smith should hold the advantage as they come up through Siberia. He does just.
Well, it's very, very Yamaha heavy at the front of the field at the moment. Four Yamahas then in the top five. Márquez on that breakaway Honda is getting away at the front of the field. Rossi must have thought there for a moment. He may have taken both of those Tech 3 riders coming out of turn four. Now look what's happening in the background. Pedrosa's losing so many places. Dani Pedrosa drops down now to ninth position. He's behind both Ducatis. He's behind Alessio Espargaró as well. And now Rossi attacks. Rossi through, passes Smith up to four.
Yeah, classic overtaking at the bottom of Lukey Heights from Valentino Rossi. He knows better than anybody those two at the front could clear off. He's got to get past Pol Espargaró as quick as he can, because Márquez and Lorenzo are setting a rare old pace at the front.
And they are clearing off indeed. Look at the gap already. Over the line they come to start the third lap between the first two, as Márquez goes quickest. That time was 0.4 seconds. But then you've got a second back to these two. Rossi dispatches a Pol Espargaró immediately. Twice a Moto2 winner here is Pol Espargaró, but he can't do anything about Rossi right now. He's got to push hard to catch those two up in front of him.
Fastest lap of the race to Márquez, 129.608. We ride with Valentino Rossi now in third place. Behind him is Pol Espargaró. Pol Espargaró trying to bite back at Rossi through the Stoner left-hander. Now they break for the hairpin. Márquez leads. Lorenzo. Espargaró not quite able to get onto the brakes as he tries to get up the inside of Rossi. Marc Márquez leads the way, and Lorenzo's having to work very hard indeed to stay with him. It's almost as if Márquez says, I'm the world champion, I'm going to rub your noses in it.
Jorge Lorenzo just wants to fight back, doesn't he? Won here last year, won the last two races in Aragon, and then Matigi last weekend. What can he do? Well, he's reduced it slightly at the end of the previous lap, but he's lost time around the first half of this lap. So let's just see what they can do. Over the brow of the hill, then down to the right-hander at turn 10. Great fight going on in the background. The two Brits are now together. It's Crutchlow attacking Bradley Smith. Crutchlow made a bit of a poor start, unfortunately. He was all right off the line, but lost ground around those first two corners. And he's now attacking Bradley Smith. for 5th and 6th position. Dovizioso is 7th and it's Aleix Espargaró. Pedrosa's running 9th from 5th on the grid. Bradle is 10th, Iannone 11th, Bautista 12th, Hernandez, Hector Barbera and Hiroshi Ayama completing the point scoring positions.
Increasing the lead now to almost 1 second. It's as if Marquez, a great shroud has been lifted off his shoulders and he's absolutely going for it. He's only won once here at Phillip Island. That was 4 years ago when he won that 125cc race. Yeah, Smith and Espargaró coming under a real challenge now from the Ducatis. Everybody working hard in pit lane, just a case of a flag-to-flag race. I don't think there's any problems at the moment, Dylan, is
well,
there?
Well, no, obviously they would have kept those bikes in dry setup until the bikes actually started, because you never know if there's a problem on the sighting lap. You need to have bike number two prepped for the dry, but they are preparing it for the wet just in case this this little shower does appear.
Crutchlow all over the rear wheel of Bradley Smith. And behind him he has Andrea Dovizioso, Aleix Espargaró, Danny Pedrosa and Stefan Bradl. We ride with Bradley Smith. Former teammates they may be. A great deal of love lost between them on the track. Here comes Crutchlow once again. Smith will not let him through as they race up over the top of Lukey Heights. Can he get up the inside as they break at the bottom of the corner? Smith breaks hard. Crutchlow breaks hard. Smith now closes right up on the rear wheel of Pol Espargaró. We ride with Pol Espargaró. There's Smith. There's Crutchlow.
And it's going to be tougher for Bradley Smith to pass Pol Espargaró on the brakes, because Espargaro's got that asymmetric front tyre, which is that little bit harder exactly on that fat patch where they're braking. Except, you know, Bradley Smith isn't going to have quite the same stability under braking as Pol Espargaró.
Down the garden straight they come. Crutchlow surely is going to have a nibble this time round. Is he going to get up the inside on the brakes? Not able to do so. Smith brakes well. Dovizioso right behind Crutchlow. The gap at the front now is over 1 second. Marquez is flying. And here come the Ducatis. It's a real Tech 3 Yamaha battle against the Ducatis. At the moment, Tech 3 are on top, but the Ducatis are really battling on. And Aleix Espargaró is closing all of the time in 8th place.
Yeah, Crutchlow putting some real heat then on his former teammate. Smith had a big wobble around turn 3 last time. What about this time? Into turn 4, Crutchlow very, very committed on the brakes. Crutchlow goes through. Smith will try and dive back underneath him, but he can't. So Crutchlow goes 5th. Demotes Bradley Smith to 6th place. Dovizioso is now going to try and get in on the app. But look at them all crowding there. That's Aleix Espargaró, Pedrosa, Bradle and Iannone all very much in this group. We're now on board with Danny Pedrosa. We're running around in 9th place. Up the front, it's still a second. It's hovering around a second between Marc Marquez and Jorge Lorenzo. Look at that fight at the top of the hill in front of us. Pedrosa pushing as hard as he possibly can. It's been a really difficult weekend, though, in general. So Crutchlow's got rid of one Tech 3 bike. What about the other? Oh, it's difficult to stop down into turn 10 this time.
Dovizioso all over Smith now. So they're fighting hard, the Ducatis. It's Yamaha Ducati. Aleix Espargaró is going to join in the fun as well. They come through the Gardiner corner. Into the Gardiner straight, but it's Marquez that leads away. The gap now is, well, he's pulled back about 0.2 seconds, Jorge Lorenzo, so this is far from over. Settled into that familiar Jorge Lorenzo rhythm, hasn't he? That is a good lap from Lorenzo. Very good lap also from Valentino Rossi in 3rd place.
Also, bear in mind, with these new rear tyres, they're a lot more heat resistant than what these guys are normally used to. Obviously designed to last race distance after what happened last year, so it is going to take them that little bit longer to bring them up to temperature.
This is a terrific battle for 4th place. Crutchlow's in there at the moment, then Pol Espargaró, Bradley Smith, Dovizioso. Aleix Espargaró really knocks Bradley Smith wide. He pushes him wide, opens the door for Dovizioso to come through as well. So Smith drops 2 places in the blink of an eye.
We saw the damage in the background. Carol Abraham, the 24-year-old Czech, then is out. But Andrea Iannone has crashed as well. Carol Abraham elsewhere on the circuit. It was Iannone who was in the background out of this Australian Grand Prix. Iannone began the lap in 11th position. And there is the damage Ducati then of the Italian race over. 2 riders out already. What happened? There's Iannone on the right-hand side. He's up the inside of Danny Pedrosa. Hits the back of Danny Pedrosa. Takes Bradle out wide as well. How much damage has Danny Pedrosa's Honda sustained?
Yeah, hits the back of Danny Pedrosa. Almost takes Bradle out as well. Marquez at the front. Still 21 and a half laps to go. Well, a little bit less now as they come down that long 900-metre start and finish straight. The Gardiner straight. What is the gap now? It's back to a second. Rossi a further 9 seconds down. So Marquez is keeping it constant around a second, but there's a long, long way to go. But what a battle for Crutchlow, Espargaro, Dovizioso, Espargaro and Smith.
Pedrosa coasting. Pedrosa effectively out of this race by the looks of things, with a damaged Repsol Honda's drop right down the order now to 18th place. That was Iannone just being assisted away there by the ever efficient Phillip Island Marshals. Marquez leads. This is lap 7 of 27. Rossi's just put in once again his personal best lap of the race. Valentino Rossi then, which is the 10th down on Marquez, but a 10th quicker than this man, his teammate Jorge Lorenzo, as he tries to close in for second position with still 21 laps to go in this Grand Prix. There's your 1-2-3, Marquez, Lorenzo, Valentino Rossi.
Right along the top end of the circuit, past the hay shed, up the hill in this spectacular Leaky Heights corner. They plunge over the top, down they go, this tight right-hander at the bottom, Marquez, Lorenzo, Rossi. Just got a glimpse there of Cal Crutchlow, who's having a superb ride in fourth place.
Well, this is the battle going on then for fifth place. Paul Espargaro is just in front of Andrea Dovizioso. Then it's Paul's brother, Elias Bradley Smith, as we know, was shuffled out wide at turn four last time around, and he's running at the back of that particular group at the moment in eighth position. Paul Espargaro done a very good defensive job so far, as I say, twice a Moto2 winner here from pole in those two races the last 2 years. You see the Swiss cheese style fairing with the holes in the front of that fairing there for Andrea Dovizioso's red Ducati. Look at the speed advantage that Ducati's got at the end of the Gardner straight.
Oh, there's Yoni Hernandez. Hernandez leading the way from Alvaro Bautista. I think it's Hiroshi Oyama is in there as well. Also Nicky Hayden and Alex De Angelis.
Dani Pedrosa still coasting at the back of the field. He's dropped to 21st position. Now you have to imagine he'll be diving into the pit lane at the end of the lap. Here he is, Dani Pedrosa then into the pits. Was hit by Iannone at turn four. Must be getting fed up of people running into the back of him. He was hit by Carol Abraham in final free practice yesterday afternoon. And it looks as though this race is run.
Certainly is. I think that is the end of the race for Dani Pedrosa. They immediately go to have a look at the rear end of the bike. It's his teammate Marc Márquez that leads away. It's just around a second, the gap. It fluctuates between the different sectors, doesn't it? This is at the bottom of Leaky Heights. There is Lorenzo. Rossi is definitely closing, though, on Lorenzo.
And with Dani Pedrosa, so they haven't pitted that bike. They've left it out in pit lane. They've put in a new rear tyre, obviously assessing any kind of damage. And it does look like he's at least going to go back out again, because if Aragon showed us anything, even when things do go wrong, you never know when you can salvage vital points.
And he needs vital points as well, because that battle's raging for second in the championship. Rossi and Pedrosa are on equal points. Lorenzo only a further three behind. Look then up the right-hand side. There's Iannone. Bang! There's the contact right at the back of Dani Pedrosa's Honda. Bradl was very, very fortunate to escape an accident himself there. And let's hope Iannone didn't take too hard a hit as he retired from this Grand Prix.
Knee, doesn't it? It was all in the same incident that Aleix Espargaro at the same time had pushed Smith wide, and Dovizioso had come through.
Look at Rossi now then. Personal best laps of the race for both Lorenzo and Rossi last time around. They're 1.3 seconds behind the leader, Marc Márquez, but only 7/10 of a second now between these two Yamaha riders. Make that 4/10. Look at Smith. Smith attacking Dovizioso. That's for seventh place. He's through.
Yeah, Smith fights back then, runs it wide. He should just hold the advantage. It's going to be tight. He does just hold the advantage as they come up through Siberia. Here is Stefan Bradl running in ninth.
So, guys, Dani Pedrosa's race is, they've got the bike. They're about to push it back into the box. I mean, it's not in there yet, so it's not technically over, and they've just waved it in. So, yes, it is over. They popped in a new tyre. It was actually part of the bike, just part of the fairing was slightly loose. They duct taped it back to the bike, but it seems to be a team decision that they won't be heading back out again.
There's a terrific all Yamaha battle for second place at the moment. Rossi has really closed up on Jorge Lorenzo. There is the gap progression this lap, and Rossi is close as they go down the Gardner straight. 18 laps to go. Perhaps not quite close enough this lap, I don't know. Rossi may come from late. No. And while this goes on, Marc Márquez is opening it up at the front.
He is, but if Rossi can get past Lorenzo, it could be very, very interesting. Rossi just set the fastest lap of the race so far. He was 1/10 of a second quicker than the race leader, Marc Márquez. Something dramatic's happened in that pack further back. Dovizioso has dropped to seventh, now taking another spot. What about Rossi, though? Right with Lorenzo as they come through the Stoner corner.
Yeah, Stoner corner. Now, will he have a go at the hairpin? Rossi on the brakes up the inside of Jorge Lorenzo. We run with him, and he has gone through. This is Rossi at his best. Valentino Rossi now up into second place. Can he start closing the gap on Márquez at the front?
Well, the next few laps should tell. We need to watch those lap times very, very closely. As I say, he's fastest rider on the racetrack at the moment. Looking back at Lorenzo, if he keeps up the pace he's maintained the last few laps, he'll start getting smaller and smaller, will Jorge Lorenzo. Now we look forward then on the spinning gyro cam. Where is Marc Márquez? Where is the quarry? He's up there somewhere, just over the top there of Lukey Heights, back down towards turn 10. Lorenzo's going to have to try and respond immediately. But I think Rossi's just got the edge at this point of the Grand Prix. Here's the move then. It's out of the Stoner corner. Ran very, very well through there to keep the momentum up. Straight through. Clean move down the inside of turn 4. Rossi goes second. This is lap 10.
Classic Phillip Island. Poor old Danny Pedrosa's second row start got hit by Andrea Noni when he crashed at the hairpin. Nothing he could do. That's the championship positions at the moment. So Rossi would be second in the championship. Lorenzo has something to say about that and dives up the inside of his teammate. This probably won't help them in their battle to catch Marc Márquez. They're not fussed about that. This is an important race. One for second place in the championship, and two, it's your teammate, isn't it?
Marc Márquez won't be fussed about it either, because he's 1.9 seconds in the lead of this Grand Prix now with 17 laps to go. So what about Rossi? Is he going to do the same thing he did last time? Feints to the inside of the Stoner corner. He'll try and dive now to our left, up the inside of turn 4. Here he comes.
And he's done it again, and there's nothing Lorenzo can do. Lorenzo made repeat his move down the garden straight into the Doohan corner. It's a terrific battle between the two Yamahas. You must take nothing away from Marc Márquez. It's his saying, this is why I am the world champion.
In the meantime though, Márquez has picked up another 0.2 seconds, 2.1 seconds in the lead. Now these dicing Yamahas, it's very entertaining, but Márquez is getting away, boys, at the front of the race. Crutchlow is now running fourth, by the way. Dovizioso is fifth, so Aleix Espargaró has lost another position. Pol Espargaró has now dropped to the very back of that pack, and he's seventh. Well, I say to the very back, Smith is still behind him, but Pol Espargaró has lost a hatful of places there. Now Smith has gone through. Smith goes seventh, Pol Espargaró is eighth. But this is your battle going on for second place between Rossi, who we're on board with, very threatening number 99 there of Jorge Lorenzo.
Yeah, this is them onto the straight. Let's have a look at those at top speeds. Lorenzo beautifully placed up the inside on the brakes into the Doohan corner. Oh, what a great shot. But Rossi leaves his braking late, and Rossi still holds the advantage. The gap at the front, 2.2 seconds. All eyes now focus on this battle for second place in the race and second place also in the World Championship. And they're telling him Danny Pedrosa is out.
Yes, that's Jorge Lorenzo's pit board. Don't forget, they're battling for second in the championship. Pedrosa wouldn't be second, third. He'd be fourth in the championship if things stay like this. So the Yamaha boys just reminding their man there, Jorge Lorenzo, you've got to think about these World Championship points. Now, who's your bets on here? Well, it's Dovizioso. Look at the two Tech 3 riders. Pol Espargaró up the inside of Bradley Smith. Looks again through turn 4. That's a great battle going on for eighth place. Side by side, seventh place make that. Pol Espargaró goes seventh now. Smith drops to eighth. And Stefan Bradl, who was almost caught up in the Pedrosa-Iannone incident, has caught this train.
Yeah, Dovizioso had to work his way through the field, didn't he? Of course, he did start down in 10th place. We ride with Stefan Bradl right at the end of that group now. Currently running in ninth place, Stefan Bradl. But he's got that group in his sight. You know, this is the battle for fifth place. A good ride now. Smith closes up on the rear wheel of Espargaró. Bradlin turn does the same to Smith. So Dovizioso in fifth place. Aleix Espargaró sixth, back with Marc Márquez. He is running away with this one. And Valentino Rossi has just opened up a little bit of an advantage now over Jorge Lorenzo as they come down into the Doohan right-hander. There's still 15 laps to go.
Well, Lorenzo was 0.3 seconds slower than the Marc Márquez leading Honda on that particular lap. Rossi was only 0.1 slower, so now he's released. Now he's passed Jorge Lorenzo. Hopefully for his sake, he won't need to defend on this lap. We can get a real idea now of the Valentino Rossi pace as we start the 13th of the 27 laps. Still just over 14 and a half laps to go, but still, Rossi's having to go defensive down into turn 4. They are battling very much for second in the championship, but their race-winning chances are decreasing all the time. The gap is now up by another tenth to 2.3 seconds.
So up through Siberia, the two Yamaha riders come. Both of them have a good records here. This is the battle for fifth. Crutchlow running in fourth place. Dovizioso, Aleix Espargaró, his brother Paul behind, and then Bradley Smith and Stefan Bradl.
Look at this as well. Wow, this is Scott Redding running up in front of Álvaro Bautista. It's his 200th career Grand Prix start. This is 10th. All the way down to Nicky Hayden in 16th place. So three great groups to watch. It's those Yamahas battling for second and third, then the Crutchlow all the way down to Bradle fight for fourth place, and this is the battle ranging for 10th place. Scott Redding hurt here last year, but great 10th place at the moment. Sorry, Dylan.
And interestingly enough, something we don't often see with the open class, Redding has actually gone with his harder compound, so the medium tyre, which all the factory and satellite bikes are going, and the only other one in that group of bikes to have the same is Hector Barbera on the GT14 Ducati.
And Jorge Lorenzo is back in front of Valentino Rossi. So Jorge Lorenzo would move into second place in the World Championship. Rossi would be third. Petrosa, who's out of the race, in fourth.
You've got to bear that in mind. There's your lap time comparison at the top left. Lorenzo responded that time, but Marquez put in a 29.8 while these Yamaha riders are putting in 30s. Look at Rossi back up the inside again of turn four. Oh, it's as close as you like. Can he get the edge on the exit? Yes, he can. Rossi goes second, but now the track's going to go left into Siberia.
Terrific stuff from both of them. Two very experienced men. Obviously, Rossi 9 times world champion. What's Jorge Lorenzo? 4 times world champion. Absolutely at it, on the limit. Nothing asked, nothing given. This is a tremendous battle for second place. And, of course, all it's doing is just helping Marc Marquez at the front. Not that I think he needed any help, to be honest with you. He looks in a class of his own. But this is terrific stuff. Lynn Jarvis, the director of racing for Yamaha, looks on. He'll like this, but he would have liked it to have been the battle for the lead, wouldn't he?
He certainly would. They're battling over second place in this Grand Prix. Let's not forget Cal Crutchlow either. We're not seeing much of him because he's doing so well in the race. He's in a very lonely fourth place, 5 seconds behind these two, but 4 seconds in front of his teammate Andrea Dovizioso on Ducati, which has far less upgrades. Back down to turn one. Now then, he sits behind him this time. I think Rossi's just going to follow Lorenzo all the way through the Doohan corner, all the way through the southern loop, and then see if he can dive up the inside of turn four. Further back, a perhaps slightly different game plan for the likes of Pol Espargaró and Bradley Smith here.
Yes, Aleix Espargaró's got in front of Dovizioso. Smith runs it a little bit wide there. Bradle is there. So there's Dovizioso. Pol Espargaró on the outside. Then it's Smith, and then it's Bradle. But big and good move by Aleix Espargaró. Back with the two Yamahas. And there's no way through at turn four that time round for Valentino Rossi. Rossi rips a rip-off visor off as they come through the hairpin. Wow, it's pretty hot here. The two Tech 3 Yamahas and Smith gets pushed very, very wide indeed. And Bradle has come through. And Pol Espargaró has now got through on Dovizioso.
Yeah, Smith hung out to dry once again there, unfortunately. Pol Espargaró, as you say, is past Dovizioso. He's then up into sixth place. So the two brothers might now go head-to-head. And remember, they're absolutely together in the World Championship as well for sixth overall. And this is a big day, actually, for them, because with Andrea Iannone out of the race, who is eighth in the World Championship, they really could cement their stranglehold on sixth place. Aleix is currently only 1 point ahead of Pol Espargaró. Bad news, though, unfortunately, for the home rider. Brock Parks has just dived into the pit lane.
Here's Marc Marquez. Haven't seen a lot of him. We haven't seen a lot of him because he's dominated this race at the front. There'll be 11 laps to go. All the interest on this all-Yamaha battle between Valentino Rossi and Jorge Lorenzo. Rossi late on the brakes, but he can't get in there. And Marquez's advantage at the front, really 3.5 seconds. One, he's riding quite brilliant at the front, and these two are swapping paint the whole time.
Well, Jorge Lorenzo, remember how badly this year started off. He was so distant in the championship. A lot of people still said that you just wait later in the year. He'll still finish second in this championship. Well, it might well happen. But look at Rossi. Look at the corner speed he can carry there through the Stoner corner. Is he committed enough on the brakes? Well, the problem for Rossi is Lorenzo's also committed enough. Slightly wide, slightly different line. But for now, Lorenzo holds the advantage.
We ride with Lorenzo back for this terrific battle for fifth place. So it's Aleix Espargaró, Pol Espargaró, Dovizioso, Bradle and Smith.
Well, it's anyone's place, this one, isn't it? Anyone's fifth place, to be honest with you. Can Aleix Espargaró break away from the group? Well, he can't quite yet because he's only 0.4 seconds up the road. We're looking back, though, in the meantime, from Pol Espargaró's bike. What about these two Yamaha riders? Lorenzo second, Rossi is third. What about Marc Marquez? If you're just switching on, yes, he is leading this Grand Prix. He's 3.4 seconds up the road.
Rossi getting as close as he can now to Lorenzo as they come onto the Gardiner straight. He knows if he can just get a little bit of a pull, a bit of a slipstream, he may be able to take him down at the Doohan corner. He's beautifully placed here, Rossi now. Rossi would come out of the slipstream. Here he comes up the inside. I don't know if there's anything Lorenzo can do. Certainly does. Leaves it that little bit later. Swoops in fourth gear. through the Doohan curve. Rossi says, right, Southern Loop, let's get through here quick. Let's get through the Stoner corner quick and then line him up for the hairpin. But Lorenzo will know he's coming.
Lorenzo is just going to pounce, isn't he, Dylan?
And guys, just a word on fourth place man Carol Crutchlow. Because the Ducatis are able to run with the medium tyre, so that's their harder option, we're probably not going to see the kind of drop-offs that we might expect from some of the guys. Obviously, Aleix Espargaró, he's gone out on that softer option rear tyre. So Carol Crutchlow, if he can keep up this constant pace, he could certainly cement that fourth place for himself. And you might be wondering, why is he doing so well? Word from the Ducati camp is that they've now just stopped trying to play around with setup and find the best kind of setup. They're just leaving the bike and just letting him ride on pretty much the same machine day in, day out, and that's certainly paying off.
Rossi's through, then here he comes up the inside of turn four replay. We're watching Lorenzo out wide that time, and Rossi is back through into second place. The problem is Marquez is now 4 seconds up the road in front of these two battling Yamaha riders. There is your race leader, even if Marquez will start closed in on now by Valentino Rossi. The gap is enormous with 10 laps to go. There's your confirmation. It says Lorenzo Rossi. Actually, boys, it's the other way around now.
Yeah, but it changed rather before with the board. There is, it's not the length, isn't it, of the Gardner straight, but a world championship winning display from Marquez. What a tremendous battle, though, between the two Yamahas. Rossi in front of Lorenzo.
Great stuff as well from Cal Crutchlow, fourth position in this Grand Prix. Let's just put this into perspective. We know Dovizioso's out there on the 14.2, Andrea Iannone was as well before he crashed. Crutchlow on the GP14 with no updates since after the summer break, and he's up there in fully dry conditions from the front of the grid, fourth in the Grand Prix, and now 5 seconds almost in front of this group battling for fifth place. It's Aleix Espargaró with a little bit of a buffer there, but it looks as though his younger brother is now closing in. Behind him is Dovizioso. Then it's Bradl, who is running ahead of Bradley Smith. Here comes Dovizioso. Can Smith take advantage of this situation?
He's had it done to him a couple of times there. He's got pushed out, hasn't he? And people have come through. Fortunately, it didn't work for him that time round. Dovizioso has got past Bradl. This, I think, will run the whole race there, don't you? I don't think we're going to get an outcome of this until the final lap of the race. It's a tremendous battle for fifth place. As you say, don't take anything away from Cal Crutchlow as well.
Oh, and one of the Hondas, that's Marquez. That is Mark Marquez, the race leader, crashes out of the Australian Grand Prix on lap 18 from a 4.1 second lead. Can you believe it?
Mark Marquez has crashed here in Australia, trying to get back in the race. He's not going to win on his own. A massive advantage. And now those two Yamahas are battling for a race victory. That is down at the bottom of Lukey Heights, I think.
Yes, it is. That's quite a high speed off for Marquez. And the front end just snapped away from him. I can't believe what we're seeing. He was on course for a record 12th equaling win of the season. Listen to this. And it's goodbye. Marquez crashes out of the race. Jorge Lorenzo then second. Valentino Rossi finds himself in the lead. It's a Yamaha 1-2.
Amazing. He looked like he was running on rails in that race, didn't he? But Marc Marquez is out of the race here in Australia. What's that? His third crash in 4 races for the world champion. Valentino Rossi could return to winning ways here at Phillip Island. Well, is anything Jorge Lorenzo can do?
I mean, this is so interesting because the temperature has dropped since we've been on the starting grid. We haven't had that kind of sun. The wind feels a little bit chillier. Remember what front tyre Marquez was on. He lost it going into that right-hander. So he was on that slightly harder front tyre than the Yamaha guys.
Both Repsol Hondas out of the race. Who on earth would have predicted that? It's a Yamaha 1-2. We've got Crutchlow on target, would you believe, for a second podium finish in 3 Grand Prix. Brilliant stuff from Cal Crutchlow. Aleix Espargaró now fourth. Everybody moves up a spot, obviously. Paul Espargaró fifth. Dovizioso sixth. And it's Smith, Bradl, Redding now ninth then from Bautista. Barbara is 11th. Hernandez 12th. Hayden De Angelis and Hiroshi Ayama inside the points. It's looking good for Rossi. Look at the lap times. He's three tenths quicker.
I tell you what, he's got the sense of victory in his nostrils. Valentino Rossi has, chasing his seventh win here at Phillip Island. It would be his sixth MotoGP win here. And he's on the charge, is the doctor. And that was an amazing mistake by Marquez. So easy from at the front. I don't know, lack of concentration. Seemed to get into Lukey Heights very, very hard, didn't he? So Aleix Espargaró, Paul Espargaró, Andrea Dovizioso, Bradley Smith and Stefan Bradl. This battle now for fourth place could go absolutely any way.
Oh, and Aleix Espargaró slightly unawares there. We're just removing a tear off, and his brother dives up the inside of the Stoner corner. That was committed stuff. Paul Espargaró goes fourth. Now then, what do you do if you're Aleix Espargaró? They're all over the place. Battle contact! Battle hits the back of Aleix Espargaró. That would have damaged the back of the forward racing machine. Those two collided at Indianapolis. They've done it again in the Australian Grand Prix. Debris in the middle of the track as well.
Stefan Bradl has gone down. We ride now with Jorge Lorenzo. I think we're trying to have a look now at Marc Márquez as well. Right, this is Lorenzo.
Well, it's all kicking off here, isn't it? Bradl's
name
tumbling down.
And there you can see Valentino Rossi. It is interesting what they say. And they're telling now Jorge Lorenzo that Márquez is out of the race.
So this will cement Rossi's stranglehold and second position in this World Championship. Lorenzo will go third. Pedrosa, who's out of this race, would obviously drop to fourth base. Both Repsol Honda riders out of the race. So how's this going to shuffle up the order now with all these dramas? I wonder how much damage that forward machine of Aleix Espargaró has.
There is Marc Márquez. He's okay. That's the main thing. But as we say, three crashes in four races. Stefan Bradl is okay. That's good news as well. Refuses the stretcher. But yeah, he did bash into the back of Aleix Espargaró. Keep an eye on that one. Here they come. We're going to watch it again. Ooh, he really did hit. And I tell you, Dovizioso did well and Smith did well to avoid that.
Yes, and look at the back of Aleix Espargaró's bike. He is now dropping back through the field, and this is why. Look at the damage. That's not a runner. That'll be out of the race. And Stefan Bradl certainly out of the race. You're right. Smith and Dovizioso did a brilliant job there.
And he's out. He's out. And he's so unhappy. He has smashed the screen with his fist. Aleix Espargaró out of the race. He can't believe it. I don't know if Valentino Rossi can believe it, but he could win again at Phillip Island. He has 6.5 laps to go. He's pulling away from Jorge Lorenzo. This is now Rossi's race to lose, but he will be aware of what happened to Marc Márquez just here when he had over 4 seconds advantage in the race.
Look at the lap times. Cal Crutchlow was the quickest of the top three last time round. He's 5.5 seconds behind the leader, 3.2 seconds behind this man, Jorge Lorenzo, who's second in the race. There is that gap confirmed, top left of the screen. I tell you what, Aleix Espargaró has got to be pretty strong to break one of those screens. His brother's now fourth. Brilliant day for Tech 3 with Bradley Smith up there in fifth place. There's your situation in the World Championship then. Rossi would be up there 8 points in front of Jorge Lorenzo, and a costly afternoon for Dani Pedrosa.
Well, Cal Crutchlow, he may be waving goodbye to Ducati, but he's bringing them podium finishes. Podium in Aragon. Looks like he's on the podium here at Phillip Island. 5.5 laps to go for the British rider, who leaves Ducati and joins LCR Honda. Well, for the test in Valencia, here is Lorenzo in second place. There's nothing he can do, I don't think. And he's now coming under a tiny bit of pressure from Crutchlow. That's the gap visually as they break for the hairpin with 5.5 laps to go.
It's been a difficult year, we all know, for Cal Crutchlow, but this is a fantastic performance. He's got his mojo back. Not that he ever lost it, but we know he was injured at Austin earlier on in the season, had to miss the Grand Prix of Argentina. There was another crash then, if you remember, because of a technical problem in the Spanish Grand Prix at Jerez. But in fully dry weather conditions, Crutchlow is absolutely flying. Look at the gap. It's down to 1.3 seconds now.
He's just pulling in, you know, metre by metre, isn't he? You've got to say, Lorenzo is fighting to hang in there at the moment to second place, and Crutchlow closing all the time now at the bottom of Lukey Heights. He has finished here second previously, Cal Crutchlow. He loves Phillip Island. He was third here in 2012, 2 years ago, so it would be his second podium finish. There is Lorenzo, there is Crutchlow. The gap when they come over the start finish line could be well under 1 second.
It was 2.2 seconds when they started the lap. It is now only half a second. Can you believe it? That's remarkable. It's almost 2 full seconds in one lap for Cal Crutchlow. He's absolutely flying. Head in hands then for Lucy, the wife, unsurprisingly. Look at all those names out of the race as well down the bottom left of your screen. Only 16 riders left in this race. At this rate, everyone who finishes will be scoring points. Michael Laverty is now in the points for PDM.
And Crutchlow closing up on Lorenzo. It's not a question of if, it's a question of when, isn't it? He's lining him up at the hairpin. Here comes Cal Crutchlow up the inside of Lorenzo, and he is through. Crutchlow into second place. Lorenzo relegated to third. Rossi is going to win here at Phillip Island. Márquez has crashed.
Don't forget, Crutchlow is on the soft compound front tyre. Jorge Lorenzo on the extra soft front compound tyre. So Crutchlow through. What is the gap to Valentino Rossi? It's 5.3 seconds. Let's monitor it very carefully. That would be a second a lap. Surely that can't happen. Even so, what a performance it is from Cal Crutchlow. On board then with the race leader.
Be interesting what this board tells of Valentino Rossi, won't it? Here he is coming up into the first part of these double left-handers. Coming into the Gardner straight, there would be four laps to go for Rossi.
Tracing
his sixth MotoGP victory at Phillip Island. The crowd will love it. 250, not out there holding up. This is 250th MotoGP appearance. Right, what's the gap? I'd say he's very safe indeed, wouldn't you? 6.2 seconds between Rossi and Crutchlow.
Now, Crutchlow was slightly quicker. Cal Crutchlow is really in the groove now. But yeah, 250 Premier Class appearances for Rossi. Don't forget as well, he started this race eighth on the grid. Pol Espargaró on board with him now. Brilliant performance. Fourth. He'll be moving up then in this World Championship to sixth, ahead of his brother, if it stays like this. Bradley Smith behind them. There's Smith in fifth place. Now further back, this is Bautista in his 200th career Grand Prix start. Across the three World Championship classes, he's running around in seventh place now. Hector Barbera is eighth. Barbera attacking Bautista for seventh. They're both in front now then of Scott Redding.
It's been an amazing race, hasn't it? All the way down the field, there's been some terrific battles. The big shot, Marc Márquez, crushing out seemingly on rails and going to win the race comfortably. This is good stuff. Bautista, here comes Redding up the inside of Barbera at the hairpin and gets past Hector Barbera.
I tell you what, Pol Espargaró might be on for a very first MotoGP podium today. He's just taken 0.7 seconds out of Jorge Lorenzo in one sector. Look at the gap, top left of the screen. It was 5 seconds. What is it this time? 4.6. He's catching him hand over fist.
For 3.5 laps to go, it's not going to be easy. There is Alex De Angelis, his teammate. Of course, Aleix Espargaró out of the race. Rossi crosses the line, three to go. Coming onto that back straight, we just got a glimpse there of Cal Crutchlow and Jorge Lorenzo. They're telling Lorenzo that Espargaró is coming. I don't know if they say which Espargaró it is.
And the interesting thing is, obviously in those top four now, only, well, Rossi has that extra soft front tire, Crutchlow with the soft, Lorenzo with the extra soft, but Pol Espargaró has the asymmetric soft front tire.
Right, we ride with Pol Espargaró, winner here last year and the year before in Moto2, having the MotoGP ride of his career. Don't forget, it is his first season in MotoGP. There we are, confirmation of what Dylan was telling us about those tyre choices.
Oh, and Pol Espargaró down, he's lost it. Any chance of a podium's gone now. That's into turn four. Bradley Smith will go fourth in this race.
Pol Espargaró, both Espargaros show their emotion. One smashes the screen with his fist. The younger one just buries his helmet in his hand. Espargaró out at turn four. He is okay. Bradley Smith now up into fourth place. There's 2.5 laps to go. Don't blink, because something could still happen.
Here we go. Watch number 44. Front end just disappears.
Happened to him in practice, didn't it?
Certainly did. Airbag suit will obviously go off. What a shame. He was chasing his first podium finish in MotoGP. There it goes, rear wheel lifts off the ground as well as he tries to stop it from happening. Left hand still on the clutch lever at that point. Look at the damage as that bike scrapes along. Valentino Rossi leads then into the penultimate lap of this Grand Prix. Crutchlow 6.1 seconds behind. It's comfortable for Rossi in the lead. It's comfortable for Crutchlow in second place. Then it's Lorenzo, but Bradley Smith, well, he's 3.6 behind Lorenzo. It should be okay now.
It should be all right, shouldn't it? But don't say it should, because so much has happened in this race. Valentino Rossi, he loves Phillip Island. We all remember the day he took the sheet from the hotel and put that number 7 in tribute to Barry Sheen when he won the race here. Then Casey Stoner came along and won 6 in a row. But Rossi now could be back on the top step of the podium at Phillip Island. What a ride by Cal Crutchlow on the Ducati in second place.
In a Honda-dominated season, and on a day on which they could have clinched both world titles for teams and constructors, this could well be a fourth win in a row for the Yamaha factory team. It would be Rossi's 82nd in MotoGP, the 108th of his Grand Prix career. Just 1.5 laps to go. Now, there's your live gap for Smith and Lorenzo at the top there. 0.4, it's not going to be enough, though. There's only 1.5 laps left in this race. Now we do have the very unusual situation of every single rider who will finish this race will score World Championship points.
Super performance by Bradley Smith. got pushed out wide a couple of times at the hairpin, people crashing all around him. He's kept his head. That's why I don't think he'd push on too hard against after Lorenzo. He knows. One lap to go for Rossi. One lap away from victory here at Phillip Island into the Doohan corner. And what a performance by Cal Crutchlow in second place.
Here we go then. There's been some special days here for Valentino Rossi. Remember 2004 when he won that first world title with Yamaha. He didn't need to pass Giubinazzi in that race, but he did. Went on to win again in 2005. But it's been those 9 years since Rossi last won here at Phillip Island.
Valentino Rossi through the southern loop up towards the Stoner corner. He is loving every single minute of this. It'll be entertaining to talk to him later, won't it? And you'll be doing that, Greg.
Remember how patient he was as well when he was attacking Jorge Lorenzo early in the race. Crutchlow
down! Oh, Crutchlow's gone down!
From second!
Crutchlow down, so Bradley Smith could find himself on the podium. Cal Crutchlow has gone down. Oh, what a race. It's all happening out there. Crutchlow down and out. Lorenzo up into second. Bradley Smith now in third place. We ride with Valentino Rossi down at Lucky Heights.
He's going to want to be ever so careful with the attrition we've seen here this afternoon. This is unbelievable. It's a Yamaha 1-2. Make that a Yamaha 1-2-3 now with Bradley Smith up there on the podium. Let's just watch Rossi first of all, though. This is turn 12.
The Doctor, Australia stands to salute Valentino Rossi. Valentino Rossi wins here at Phillip Island.
Amazing Grand Prix. It's his 250th Premier Class Grand Prix, and he's just as good as he always was. Rossi does it in Australia. Here comes Lorenzo and Bradley Smith. They will be going mad back in Oxford. He's on the podium for the first time ever in the Premier Class. Brilliant. Dovizioso fourth, and can you believe it? Hector Barbera will finish fifth on the Avintia Ducati. What a mixed-up Grand Prix, and what can you say? What disappointment. Look at this battle. It's Barbera, it's Redding, it's Bautista. Barbera does finish fifth. Bautista sixth in his 200th career Grand Prix start. Scott Redding seventh to lead the customer Honda battle from Oyama De Angelis, who started at the very back of the grid. And Nicky Hayden 10th. Only 14 finishes, would you believe, from the 23 starters.
Wow. We knew that drama would go all the way to the end. Poor old Cal Crutchlow, right at the end there, Valentino Rossi. He's done it again, hasn't he? Just don't rule him out. Great ride. What happened to Marc Márquez crashing out with such a big lead? So much incident, and just compounded on that last lap when Cal Crutchlow looked to be in a safe second place and went down. You take advantage of whatever happens. Valentino Rossi knows that better than anybody else. 250 MotoGP races, and he's won here at Phillip Island.
As you said in the Grand Prix itself, Nick, sixth Premier Class win then here on the island. That's amazing. You couldn't have scripted that, could you?
You just couldn't have done.
You most certainly could not have scripted that one. And you just knew something was probably going to happen on the last lap, didn't you? Because it was happening all the time. Some were mistakes when riders clashed with each other. Others, Marc Márquez, we didn't see what happened to Cal Crutchlow. We're just about to find out, I think. This is at the hairpin on the last lap, front end.
The tricky turn four again.
Yeah, both under braking there. And remember, both those guys we just mentioned beforehand, they were on the tyre one step harder.
Oh, wow. Need a lie down in a dark room, I think, at the moment. That was some race. And it's again, it's a different type of race, wasn't it? It just brings up so much.
Hector Barbera into Parc Fermé as well as the leading open runner. Hector Barbera's finished this race inside the top five. Bradley Smith on the podium. Yamaha 1-2-3. Can I just say as well, if you're a marshal here at Phillip Island watching this race back, well done, because you've had such a busy weekend.
You have. Well done, Valentino Rossi. 250th MotoGP race. His second win of the season. That was absolutely superb. I think, well, there you go. Rossi now leading the way in that battle for second place in the championship. I don't think that will be on his mind one single bit. Jorge Lorenzo looks really disappointed. Obviously a problem tyre-wise, you would think, for Jorge Lorenzo.
Just proving the calibre of Lorenzo, really, the fact he kept that one on the road and got it home to second place in this Grand Prix, but he was 11 seconds behind Rossi in the end. Bradley Smith closed right in through only 1.4 seconds behind Lorenzo. Another lap or two, and he may have even been second in the race. Not that he'll be complaining about third. Valentino Rossi, though, amazing stuff. It's his 20th season in the Premier Class next year, and he's still up there, 35 years of age. I think the only way you can really gauge just how good he is by seeing how good Marc Marquez is when he's 35.
Well, Lorenzo is very disappointed. It's a second place. It's something he couldn't really battle, could he? And once Rossi had gone past and once Marquez had gotten the lead as well, you can just see by his face, Wilco Zielenberg's face. There's the kangaroo. Here come the crowd. They're treated to an Australian victory by Valentino Rossi. Well done, Bradley Smith, his first podium in MotoGP, and he had to fight off the likes of Dovizioso and all the other crashes all around him.
Yeah, and that is no fluke for Bradley Smith either, because he was rapid in qualifying. Don't forget, he may have dropped back in this race, but he started it fourth on the grid. He missed out on the front row by only 6,000. In fact, you know what? He missed out on only second place on the grid by a few hundredths of a second. So Bradley Smith has had the pace all weekend long here. Yes, it's true, the Hondas have been struggling. It did look quite Yamaha favourable, didn't it, coming into the race? But even so, you've got to be in it to win it. That was amazing stuff.
Well, this championship never ceases to amaze you. Round 16, another extraordinary race. Rossi wins from Lorenzo. Bradley Smith's first ever podium in MotoGP. Then Dovizioso, Hector Barbera, Alvaro Bautista, Scott Redding, Hiroshi Oyama and Alex Angeles. The big news, Marquez was leading by over 4 seconds when he crashed out at the bottom of Lucky Heights. Nicky Hayden picks up some really hard-earned points. Yoni Hernandez, Danilo Petrucci, Michael Lafferty, Mike DiMeglio. And that's it, 14 finishes. Look at the fallers, Crutchlow and Espargaro. Marquez was the really big faller. Danny Pedrosa got hit by Andrea Iannone when he went down. Also, cruel luck for Aleix Espargaro. He was hit by Stefan Bradl when he went down.
Just as he was at Indianapolis when he was hit by Stefan Bradl. This is what it does then for the Riders' World Championship with two Grand Prix to go in Malaysia and Valencia. Marquez, as we know, he's wrapped it up already. How close might they be to him at the end of the season? It's a 57-point lead now. Rossi looking very good for second overall. Lorenzo third. Bad day for Pedrosa. Drops from second to fourth in the World Championship. Then it's pretty much status quo. Dovizioso still his lonely fifth from Aleix and Paul Espargaro. Smith is now ahead of Andrea Iannone for eighth in the riders' standings. And Bradl completes the top 10. Don't forget, Leon Camier scored a point earlier on in the season. Seems a long time ago now. So much drama has happened since then. And there he is then. Bradley Smith is on the podium for the first time in MotoGP.
Yeah, second podium at Phillip Island. He was second here 5 years ago in the 125cc race. I suspect he can't believe it. So much was happening all around him, but you keep your head when that happens, don't you? And he got mocked back a couple of times and fought his way back. I think Lynn Jarvis is smiling. Yamaha 1-2-3. I would think that would do very nicely. Thank you very much. Hello, Japan. can we put a bit more money into the teams, please?
Amazing stuff, and it's the second 1-2 of the year as well for the factory team. The first was at Misano, that one was won by Rossi as well. That's what I was saying in the race, though. Yamaha's won the last four races.
Watch this. Front end, wasn't it?
He had a 4 second lead at the time. It's down into turn 10.
Are you still watching, Dylan?
I can't see a screen. It's basically like Misano down here, yeah, with the Rossi winning the pitch invasion. Right, yeah.
We're just watching Marquez go down, losing the front end. I mean, but you know what? It's such a big advantage.
Look, I've been chatting with people here in Parc Fermé, and the guys that went down in that corner, they had this asymmetric front, and it's that one step harder, and it has been getting that tiny little bit colder. And you know, you imagine they would have done a lot of left-hand corners just before getting there, and that right shoulder, even before getting onto the softer part, would have been that little bit colder than on the extra soft front.
Well done, Jorge Lorenzo. Sort out Valentino Rossi. Congratulate him with his race win. He's very disappointed, Lorenzo. It'll be interesting when he speaks to you, Greg, what he has to say. Obviously was a problem. There we go, Repsol Honda. Movistar Yamaha are not giving up the fight, are they? Nil pois for Marquez and Pedrosa today. And 1-2 for the Yamaha factory team.
I know they've inflicted huge damage, though. It was an 85-point advantage before the race, and now look at that, down to 40-odd points. All Repsol Honda needed to do today was outscore the Yamaha factory team by 5 points. He certainly didn't do
well,
that.
Well, they were unlucky with the Pedrosa incident.
Yes,
but Marquez, well, I'd say rider error. It's just interesting what we hear about the tyre. And here we go. Same story, of course, with the Constructors' Championship. There's just one rider scores points. So Valentino Rossi brings a maximum for Yamaha, and Honda don't score any, well, don't score any at all with the factory team.
A disaster, actually, for Honda. They only scored, well, the leading Honda was Álvaro Bautista in sixth position. That'll be 10 World Championship points, so 15 they catch up by there to bring that advantage down. Yamaha to 45 points from 60. There is your track invasion. Dylan Gray's in the middle of that carnage somewhere.
We'll find him a bit later on. What a day we've had here at Phillip Island. How can you not enjoy Grand Prix motorcycle racing? Amazing Moto 3 and Moto 2 races. And then, if you blinked in this race, something happened, didn't it? Good things, bad things, everything. And then, just to crown it all, Valentino Rossi wins the race.
And there's your tyre combination. So it's the extra soft front compound for both of them. So same tyre combination with the medium on the rear.
Yeah, it was the front tyre, Dylan, if you're still there, that was causing the crashes, wasn't it?
Well, yeah, exactly. It was breaking into that right-hander. Look at the corner combination is providing very, very long left down the straight. Then, yes, you've got a right, but mainly braking. Then a very, very, very long left. Then stone a corner, a left, and then it's this hard braking zone into the right.
Well, people will be saying, though, why did Lorenzo struggle so bad when Rossi didn't, bearing in mind it was the same combination?
We're going to find that out in a minute, I would think, because there's obviously something very much wrong with Lorenzo, and you could just tell by his face how disappointed he was. So Alessio Spyro leads away in the open class. Scott Redding, Hiroshi Oyama, Nicky Hayden. And nice to see Michael Lafferty picking up some points he deserves. And Mike DiMeglio, they soldier on. They didn't crash. Others did. They deserve the points.
Yeah, you've got to be in it to win it, as they say. To finish first, you first have to finish and so on. This is the incident between Iannone and Pedrosa earlier in the race. There's the touch into turn four. Iannone, as you can see, very much out. Pedrosa had to retire into the pit lane. Look, incidents involving Pedrosa and Iannone on lap 6 and Bradle and Aleix Espargaró on lap 20 to be reviewed.
Yeah, what can they do now, to be honest? Well, they can take some point, penalise them in some way. I don't know. It's into that hairpin. It's pretty hairy there. Ooh, Bradle really did bash into the back of Aleix Espargaró though, didn't he? Really hit him hard. Let's have a look at it again. Here we go.
What's the white bike on the left? So he dives at the inside of Dovizioso. Sits Dovizioso up first of all. Smith on the outside. There was nothing Aleix Espargaró could have done there.
There's not. But he seemed to be clean through on Dovizioso, didn't he?
He
was just got in there too hot. It's. Let's let race. You watch this. This is what happens when you fail to finish a race when it's not your fault. Aleix Espargaró just cannot believe it, and he causes further damage to the bike.
Yeah, it's the second time he's been involved in the collision with Bradle.
Yeah, that's nice to see Hector Barber in there as well, isn't it? The first of the open bikes. There's a guy that's won 125 and 250cc Grand Prix, had some horrendous injuries. There you go. He stayed on, and he's the open class winner here in Phillip Island.
And not just the open class winner, but he's fifth in the Grand Prix outright.
Yeah,
okay,
right.
He was 30 seconds behind, but he was fifth. He finished in the top five this afternoon. Did Hector Barbera from 14th on the grid. Great stuff for Bautista. You have to feel for him as well. So many struggles with the rear tyre spinning this year, particularly this weekend. He finishes his 200th career race in sixth place. Scott Redding, seventh, so he's the leading customer Honda from Hiroshi Oyama. De Angelis, from the very back of the grid, fought all the way up to ninth. Hayden, tenth. Then it was Hernandez, Petrucci, Laverty, and DiMeglio picking up 2 points. There's Bruce Kangaroo in the background. I think he's called Bruce, isn't he?
Well, everything's packed up tonight. You won't believe the activity. You think this is hectic. Everything packed up. Three jumbo jets of equipment will be flying out to Malaysia tomorrow. Pol Espargaró, big crash, just going in again to turn four.
Guys, I'm just down here in Parque Fermo with Massimo Marigalli from Yamaha. Mayo, fantastic result for you guys. Jorge didn't look so happy coming in there, seemed to be dropping off the time. Did he tell you guys what the problem is?
Yeah, the front tyre basically is completely finished, and he dropped. He never dropped during the practices. I was worried about this problem with Vale, but anyway, for us, a part of this problem has been a really a good weekend. We knew that we could be fast here. Mark, unfortunately, Mark has crashed for himself, but for us it's a really great result. Three Yamaha on the podium, it's a long time ago, happened last time.
Great, thanks a lot for that, Mario.
Chuck Miller looks on. What a Moto3 race we've had. We're not going to tell you anything else. We've had three unbelievable races. So here we go, on to the podium. What a roar he will get. His 250th MotoGP race. And of course, he had to win it. And of course, he did win it. Valentino Rossi wins. Jorge Lorenzo in second place. And Bradley Smith, for the first time in his career, on a MotoGP podium after finishing third.
There's Mick Doohan in there. Legend in his own right, particularly in this part of the world. Jorge Lorenzo perhaps just explaining what happened there. Such a fine line between staying on the track and going off it. Look at Bradley Smith's face on the podium for the first time. He kept his head as well when he dropped down to, what was it, about eighth place at one point.
Yeah, he got knocked wide a couple of times at the hairpin. Others were crashing all around him. And it's easy to say that's what you have to do in this situation. So here we go. One would imagine Lynn Jarvis. Is Lynn Jarvis going out there for Yamaha? I think he should, really. There's Mick Doohan in the background. Congratulations to Valentino Rossi, two great world champions. Bradley Smith for the first time on the podium in MotoGP. Second place, Jorge Lorenzo. But on his 250th MotoGP appearance, Valentino Rossi wins here at Phillip Island in Australia. So Lynn Jarvis from Yamaha receives the Constructors' Trophy. Not hard to work that one out, is it? 1, 2, 3. And Bradley Smith on the MotoGP podium for the very first time. Third place for the rider from Oxford. Mick Doohan making the presentation to Jorge Lorenzo in second place. Shake of the hands also to Valentino Rossi and Bradley Smith. But his sixth Premier Class win here at Phillip Island. His 250th MotoGP race. Valentino Rossi wins here at Phillip Island in Australia. For that crowd, it could have been an Australian rider winning the race, couldn't it? Congratulations to Valentino Rossi. Congratulations to Yamaha. No time to celebrate, although there'll be some celebrations in Cowes tonight, I can tell you, with Valentino Rossi and his team. Next stop, Sepang in Malaysia. What a day of racing.
Remarkable. 1-2-3 for Yamaha, second 1-2 result of the season for the factory team. And Yamaha's won the last four Grand Prix now.
And, well, you've got to think for poor old Cal Crutchlow, who was running second and crashed out on that last lap. Mark Marquez had over 4 second advantage and crashed also in the race. Hector Barber's already joined us. What a performance by him. Fifth place and top open class rider. The others, I think, would take a bit longer, because I think there's a fair bit of champagne flowing. All onto the podium they come, all in the right colours. Yamaha 1-2-3, the boss of Yamaha racing up there as well. I would think that will be a very happy picture back in Japan.